Do you want to learn how to do this cool effect of neon lines? To be able to highlight objects or people in your video. Once inside DaVinci Resolve, we go to the Fusion module. We must go to the Effects tab and look for the effect, Planar Tracker. Another way to do it is by pressing the keys, Control plus Space. The search engine will appear. Now you simply write, Planar Tracker. Select the effect and press the Add button. Like this, we'll automatically connect the node with the Planar Tracker effect. Once we have done this, we select the Planar Tracker 1 node and change the tracker mode from point to hybrid. Now go to the second tab, Options, and go down the Trail Length slider. Decreases from 5 to 2. This will remove a lot of tracking points from the tracking that we don't need. We go back to Controls. Now we need to set the reference time. We must select at what moment we want it to start following the movement of the phone. Let's select the first frame of the video clip, frame 0, and then press the Set button. Click. The next step is to select the object or person in the video in which you want to place the colored lines. In this case, I am going to select the entire phone, which is where I will place the neon lines. It is done. Click on this icon so that it begins to track all the movement that the phone makes. But in this, if there is a problem, the mobile screen also has a movement. There is a person who moves. DaVinci Resolve's Planar Tracker will also follow that movement. Now you will see how the tracking starts to go a little crazy, from the top and to the right. If something similar happens to you, I recommend you do the following to solve it. We eliminate all the tracking that we have done, since it is not right, and I return to establish the reference frame. To solve this problem, we are going to change the type of movement to one more suitable for this video. Translation, rotation, and scale. Translation, the mobile moves left to right, up and down. Rotation, the mobile has a slight rotation movement. Scale, the mobile moves and approaches the camera, therefore it increases its size. This type of movement is perfect for this video. Now we are going to select a much smaller part of the phone to track. The camera area with dots and the black line is perfect to be able to do the tracking. We select only this part, and so we avoid all movement of the person that appears on the mobile screen. We press the rattle icon until the end, but as I mentioned before, make sure you are in the first frame of the video. Press the button, and we can see what it does the tracking correctly throughout the video. Once it ends, we check that everything is fine. Now we can export all the tracking data, creating a planar transform. We'll now add a new node called Planar Transform. We can delete the old node of Planar Tracker 1, since we are not going to use it again. Then we connect the new node of Planar Transform 1 in this way, to create a union node automatically. Okay, the node should be this way. The next step is to create a colored background by clicking on this icon. This node will be to choose the color of your neon lines. In this example, I am going to choose yellow, but you can choose the color you want. When you have chosen the color, click on the Background 1 node and click on this spline icon. This will allow us to make a layer around the edges of the mobile phone. Now we click on our video clip and carefully create a layer around the phone. Try to be as precise as possible, since this it is an important part. Okay, when we finish, we will have a color layer that follows the movement of the phone. To make the color layer only shown on the edges of the phone, we must deactivate the solid option. And now we will only have the yellow edges. To increase the thickness of the border, we simply move the border width bar until we find the border size we are looking for. I think it is okay. Also recommend adding some soft edges. We already have the edges finished. Don't worry if the lines go over the fingers of the hand. We'll fix that in a moment. Now we're going to create the animation effect on the lines. Click above the Spline 1 node and select the frame of the video where you want the animation of the lines to start. Go to position and create a keyframe at 0. And create another keyframe and length also at 0. like this. Now we select the frame where we want the animation to end. And we create two new keyframes in position and in length. In length we put 1. And in position we put 5. Our effect will be like this. Just need to add the neon effect and make the line not pass over the fingers. Press the Ctrl plus space keys. And look for the effect, soft glow. Now we do the following. We disconnect the planar transform node from merge 1. We connect planar transform with soft glow. And soft glow with merge 1. If you have followed the steps, you should already have a neon effect. To configure the neon effect to your liking, increasing or decreasing its brightness, you just have to move the threshold and gain bars until you find the configuration that you like the most. Now yes, we are going with the final part of the video. Make the line not go over the fingers. To do it, we are going to leave Fusion and go to the editing module. In the editing module, we have the video with the effect of the lines applied. Now we must put the original video above the clip that has no effect. Should be like this. Above the video without lines, and below the video with the effect of the yellow lines. After placing the video clips, we go to the module color of DaVinci Resolve. We select the video that does not have yellow lines. And we right-click to add an alpha output. Now we connect our node with the alpha output that we have created. We go to the Power Windows panel. And there we select the pen. Now we simply have to select all the part of the finger that passes over the mobile. The mask we are making is the one that will cover the yellow line of the effect. Once we have finished, we increase the softness little. And then we have to go to the tracker panel. We click on the pointing arrow to the right. Now the mask that we have made on the finger will follow the entire movement of the finger. Do you see that the yellow line no longer crosses the big toe? We make sure that everything is correct. And now we would do the same with the other two fingers to make it perfect. For this, we click on the pen icon with a plus symbol. So we can add another mask. Now we do exactly the same as we have done before. You already have your incredible effect finished. And nothing more. Thanks for watching the video, and see you next time.